I think that there's probably no better place on earth to have a message not only of peace, but against nuclear weapons than Hiroshima and Nagasaki. I guess Hiroshima, perhaps because it was the first place, but really the two are paired in that as being the only two places where a nuclear bomb was dropped with the intention of destroying cities. Of course, it's just a symbol. This symbol hasn't done much to prevent 6, 7, 8, 10 governments of the world from developing or wanting to develop nuclear weapons. Maybe they should all come here and take a tour of this museum and take a look at the radiation burns and the destruction of the city and realize that the weapons that they're playing with today are 1,000 times more powerful than the ones that destroyed the city around us. Maybe the people are living in an illusion. You know, during the Cold War, there was this ideology called mutually assured destruction, MAD. And that was to say that, okay, if we have 1,000 weapons pointed at all their cities, and they have 1,000 weapons pointed at all our cities, if anybody starts this war, it'll wipe everything out. There'll be certain destruction on both sides, therefore it's a deterrent. That's the best we could come up with, you know? 2,000 years of civilization, that's the best they can come up with, is to threaten total annihilation as a way to prevent war. I mean, to me, that's an indication of insanity. Or perhaps not insanity. Maybe we could forgive somebody for being insane. This is the disease of rationality, I think. There's a rationality there, and perhaps a perfectly sane rationality that says, we'll do this. We can use these weapons, we can survive on the basis of destroying the other side. So this is a symbol, in a sense, but it's only a symbol because we have the proliferation of nuclear weapons around the world today. South Africa came to their senses when Mandela was elected president after the destruction of apartheid. They got rid of their nuclear weapons, but the Israelis still don't admit that they even have them. So there's no mention, even in this museum, of the Israeli nuclear capability. That little map that shows all the countries that have nuclear weapons with the missiles sticking out, there's none on Israel, and there should be there. So it's a symbol, it's a powerful symbol, but symbols only go so far, and I'm not quite sure what to do beyond having the symbol. But certainly, without this symbol, without the possibility that to come here you have to bear witness to this destruction and the potential for this destructive power, that at least it's there, and it'll always be here. And with monuments like this, place not just photographs, but actual places that you can see, maybe it will have an effect on people. I'm sure that the hope of having such a memorial and a park and having these yearly rallies is precisely to hope that the world can come to some other way of ensuring peace without this ideology of mutually assured destruction.